tracking on off towards the northeast, perhaps bringing some wintry weather into the northeastern U.S. As a matter of fact, already seeing some wintry weather. Now, here's where we're looking at the action right now. Snow advisories in effect for parts of Kentucky, West Virginia, and extreme western Virginia here. Already snow falling in these areas. Looking at rain as we head back a little farther to the south. And in Florida, you're still looking at rain here around the Tampa Bay area and also around Daytona Beach.
And there has been plenty of rain in the Pacific Northwest. So those of you watching tonight from Seattle and Portland, continue.
Southeast, all of this associated with our front and our area of low pressure that's going to be moving off to the northeast. Looking at rain as we head into Florida and in parts of the Carolinas, then head up into West Virginia, Kentucky, and parts of Western Virginia. And we're looking at snow here, snow advisories in effect there as well. Now in the northwest, we're looking at rain here and maybe a little bit of snow in some of the higher elevations. Check first into the northeast shows us a little action here from New York back to Philadelphia, Baltimore, and then even farther to the south as we head into parts of Georgia and Alabama, still looking at some light rain occurring here. Well, it's the holiday season and it's time to do a little shopping. We'll have your forecast.
West of Washington, and some sleet and snow around New York City.
That's right. We're also going to check out the rain in the Pacific Northwest, but first, it was a cold, snowy morning in portions of the South. Right now, a chilly in the upper Midwest, temperatures falling into the teens, 20s, 30s, 40s behind a frontal boundary here, still mild to the south of it, still in the 60s here, but things will be cooling down as this area moves on through. Our area of low pressure is going to be something we're really going to be paying close attention to here at the Weather Channel as it produces rain and, more importantly, as it produces snow here, and we're already seeing snow in some areas. It's going to be tracking on off towards the northeast and already bringing snow to some places, and it will continue on into the northeastern U.S. A closer look at a few radars show us we're seeing rain here in the Carolinas. Head up into West Virginia, back into Pennsylvania, and into parts of Virginia and Kentucky. We're looking at snow falling here. Snow as far north as New York City, actually. But we're looking at rain here in the south, and as we head a little bit farther to the south into Florida, we're looking at some rain here as well. From Daytona Beach back to Tampa and Fort Myers, and you're looking at rain and thunderstorms in the forecast for much of the state.
And stating right up I-95 in the Jersey Turnpike, just checking LaGuardia right now, you've got some light snow there, although it's been mixing with sleet and rain. Temperatures in the mid-30s. Sleet and rain at JFK. It's raining out on the island, but this will be all snow north and west of the city. And in southern New England, Boston, back through the Berkshires and in through the Litchfield Hills of Connecticut, a snow event, so get the shovels and get the plows ready. Or get the snow blowers ready. You may not own a plow for your driveway. If you do, you're in pretty good shape, though. Here's your snowfall forecast. Now, we've got a strip of 6 to 12, but we're going to want to kind of add just a little verbiage here that it looks like it will be closer to the 6 than the 12, but still a pretty good snow event east and west. More snow for the Rockies, Colorado through the Bitterroot. Thank you.
The Z, SCC's newest patented idea for winter driving control. Z product design guarantees constant contact with the road and requires no adjustment on the inside of the tire. Already used on thousands of police vehicles, Z-Chain and Sure Grip Z are now available to you. Could these be the best traction products for safety, convenience, and durability?
SCC, for the perfect traction you need.
Now you can get the Chase Tornado.
Austin, 5 inches. And believe it or not, in Charleston, it snowed 3 inches in 1 hour. Now, this is not the sign of things to come. This is a pretty quick-moving event. So you're not going to get a whole lot more through the mountains of West Virginia. For instance, in western areas like Charleston and Huntington. And over in eastern Kentucky, 3 inches at Jackson. Here's the current weather map. We're watching an area of storminess. We've got the low. We've got the cold air moving in. So those are the ingredients to get snow in the Northeast. But this is not a major storm by any stretch of the imagination, but it will be moving right up the front over the eastern shore, over Salisbury and Ocean City, out over the Atlantic, and then it will throw moisture back into the cold air. So some spots may get 6-7 inches of snow, but most of you will be in the 3 to 6 inch category as the cold air moves in tonight. This storm is going to go right like this, south of Long Island. So if you're watching from New York City, and Philadelphia, in the city areas, in the metro areas, primarily a snow-rain mixture event, a lot of slush. But as you get north and west of New York City, out through the hills of northwest Jersey, and into the Great Gorge area, up through the Hudson Valley, lower Hudson Valley, Westchester County, out through the Berkshires, and in southern New England, it's going to be all snow. For instance, if you're watching from Boston, Hartford, or Providence, we're looking at all snow with temperatures already running 34, 35, and dry air in place. Wednesday afternoon, there's a storm. Again, this is not a major nor'easter like we had a couple weeks ago with the wind and rain, but it's got enough oomph to throw moisture back in the cold air and create what we think will be some snowfall. Let's go to the radar and show you what's going on right now. And you can see that moisture riding right up the Interstate 95 through Baltimore, Philadelphia, up through the Jersey Turnpike. And checking the latest obs, LaGuardia now light snow, but the temperature is running at last hour 39 degrees. So as you can imagine, it's not really sticking. Out on the island at Islip, moderate sleet being reported. Temperatures there in the mid-30s. We've had sleet and rain mixed at JFK. And even some snow and sleet mixing around Newark Airport. Those are the major New York City airports. Basically, what you're seeing across the rest of the area here is not reaching the ground, but eventually it will. Boston, Providence, and Hartford, that snow getting underway in the early hours of Wednesday morning and continuing through at least midday on Wednesday. Now, in Washington and Baltimore, north and west of the city, you'll get some snowfall. In fact, right now, we've got some light snow at Dulles Airport. And as you get out in Loudoun County and Fairfax County, a better chance of some snowfall there. But south and east of Baltimore and D.C., maybe a changeover, mixture with some wet snowflakes. We're not expecting any problems on the highways there. And certainly in Salisbury and Ocean City, my home area, where you really have to have just the exact, the perfect ingredients for snow, it's going to be a rain event. Now, how much snowfall occurs? Here's a forecast now that we've increased this a little bit. And you can see a swath of white, more than 6 inches. A cold morning down to near zero in the Midwest, but without the wind around New York City and Boston and Hartford and Providence, the first significant snowfall of the season, especially north and west of New York City and Philadelphia. But in Boston, Providence, and Hartford, we're thinking it's going to be all snow, and you're not going to have to deal with the slush or the rain or the sleet as temperature is a little bit colder. Let's go to the radar right now. And here comes that train of moisture into the cold air. And it's plenty cold in this area from Boston back to Hartford to support all snow. A lot of this, by the way, is not reaching the ground yet, but it eventually will do that early hours of Wednesday morning in a couple of hours. We've got snow, sleet, and rain all mixed together at all the major airports around New York as everything moves off to the northeast. So we'll be watching the highways there and also the higher terrain of the Rockies, generally above 8,000 feet. Lower elevations, it's still raining in Seattle and Portland, and rain showers southeast in Florida continue. And watch the wind in the northeast.